हेलो गाइस, हेयर वी प्रोवाइड यू ऑडियो डिक्टेशन इन ओरिजिनल वॉइस ऑफ डॉक्टर जी डी विस्ट एट अ स्पीड ऑफ 100 बर्ड पर मिनट. इफ़ यू वांट मोर दीज टाइप डिक्टेशंस एट अ डिफरेंट स्पीड ऑफ ऑल बुक्स हिंदी और इंग्लिश देन सब्सक्राइब लाइक शेयर और कमेंट्स ऑल्सो ऑन माई चैनल. And lot of thanks of any kind of suggestion. Now ready?
Exercise 39. The defense plea that PW2 had received the injuries on the evening of June 23. And not in the morning of June 24 gains credence from the fact that an incident between the two sides had admittedly taken place on the evening of June 23, 1995. In the face of this admitted position and the medical evidence, it is difficult to accept that the injuries found on the person of PW2 were received by him in the morning of June 24. From this, either of two inferences would logically follow. 1. PW2 was not present at the occurrence in which the deceased was killed in the morning. The occurrence in which the deceased was killed did not take place in the morning of June 24, and he was not killed in the manner as suggested by the prosecution. Both the inferences are equally damaging to the prosecution case. In view of the facts and the circumstances, it would be highly unsafe to uphold and sustain the appellant's conviction for the offense of murder, and the prudent and safe course would be to give him the benefit of doubt. Accordingly, he is acquitted of the charges under section 302 and 324 IPC. The next appeal is directed against the judgment of the Punjab and Haryana High Court in criminal appeals numbers 2013 of 1996, confirming the appellant's conviction under section 302 of the Penal Code and the sentence of life imprisonment awarded to him by the trial court for having committed the murder of Kamlesh. In his statement before the police, he said that in the morning he, along with his two younger brothers, Ram Kumar, PW6, and Kamlesh, the deceased, was sitting on the chabutara of their baithak in village Keshopur when Kamlesh proceeded for his house to bring the clothes for getting ready to go to Faridpur, where he was due to appear in the BA examination. As he reached the chapal where the lane turned, he was waylaid by the accused Karam and Rampal, who were armed with knives. As to the cause of the incident, he stated that shortly before the occurrence, his younger brother Suresh was elected as the village sarpanch. He did not pay any heed to his demands.